It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hey there, Eagles. Welcome to school for the week of April 13th.
Let's kick off the week by turning to Mrs. Madsen's class for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ready, stand. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, Ms. Madsen's class. Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Armstrong this week.
We've got a busy week in front of us. How exciting. Next, let's check in on the weather porch.
This is the weather at the end of the week last week. And it looks kind of cloudy. And this is the weather. On Monday, it's going to be really nice, but on Tuesday, it's going to be kind of windy. Wednesday is going to be colder, so you probably need to bring a jacket. But by the end of the week, it's going to be more warm.
Thanks for the update. Looks like we'll have another taste of winter roll through this week. Last week, we resumed our Clash of Classes activities with the Jump the Line Challenge. Take a look.
So cool. Keep up the great work, Eagles. Our next activity will be this Friday. It's called the Storm the Castle Fun Run. We look forward to seeing you there. It's time once again for another weekly whip round.
Whip
We said it last week, but it's amazing what you can cram into a three-day week. Keep it up. Let's check in on the Armstrong Reading Blast-Off.
Butterfly in the sky, I can go twice as high. Take a look, it's in a book, a reading rainbow, a reading rainbow. I can go anywhere.
I read The Dark Diary series. It is about a girl named Nikki, and she is in junior high, and she gets in a lot of trouble, and she has a worst nightmare. Her name is Mackenzie, and she is popular, and Nikki likes her boy. His name is Brandon, and find out what happens next to her adventure if you read this book.
Nice work, readers. You have such great recommendations. Mr. Bodden surprised the classes recently at the recipients of the Astonishing Attendance Award for February and March. Take a look.
Okay, I have an exciting announcement. You guys won the Astonishing Attendance Award for the month of February. And you guys won the Astonishing Attendance for the month of March. April Fools! No, I'm just kidding, you really did win. Okay.
Congratulations to those classes, job well done. This week we'll do a unique kind of emergency drill. Let's turn to Mr. Howe to learn more about the Great Utah Shakeout.
Hey there, Eagles! On Thursday this week, the entire state of Utah will be participating in what's called the Great Utah Shakeout. Like we do every month with fire drills or other emergency procedure drills, the Great Utah Shakeout is an opportunity for us to practice how we would respond if there were an earthquake. And living in Salt Lake City and in Utah, we are in an earthquake zone and we want to be prepared. If an earthquake happens, you'll know it because everything will be shaking and you'll hear a lot of things that accompany shaking. We need you to respond with the following. In an earthquake, you will drop, cover, and hold on. I want you to say those together with me right now. Drop, cover, and hold on. If you can remember those three things, you're going to do very, very well in an earthquake. When you drop, cover, and hold on, you'll get under your desk or something else that can keep you as safe as possible from other things that could be falling during an earthquake. Your tables in your classes should work great for that. Drop, cover, and hold on. You'd remain in that position during the entire shaking. After the shaking stops, you can count aloud with your whole class until you get to 60. If the shaking has not resumed before you get to 60, you will exit the building and line up outside just as we do during our fire drill procedures. That is what we'll be doing on the afternoon of Thursday, April 17th for the Great Utah Shakeout. We'll be doing the afternoon because we'll be doing our testing in the morning. It's slated to start at 2:30 on that day.
Thanks, Mr. Howe. We'll be ready.
That's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is ABC News.